set together, because I really want to bless y'all today, and I want to do a little demonstration on this Sunday. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So I need about 3 good volunteers. Amen. Some strong volunteers. Amen. Preferably grown people. Kids always would volunteer for grown people. Amen. Amen. I need some grown people. Grown people, y'all don't want to have church today? Y'all, can y'all participate in the service? I just need 3 volunteers on this Sunday. Amen. They're not coming. Thank you. Amen. Thank you. But it's all right. It's okay. We can get that ready for me. Amen. 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 Thank you, sister. Amen. And do me a favor. I got some notes on my blessing there. Can you bring them to me? I read them down in blue if you can find those for me. Amen. Amen. And I just want to do something because I love to cook. Spread out for me while I'm doing this. I love to cook. Y'all probably can see that I love to eat too. Amen. And it's all right though. Amen. Amen. But sometimes good stuff is just good stuff. Amen. Amen. You hold that bowl for me. Amen. Amen. Don't pay no attention to what's on it. Amen.
Okay.
because there is life and death in your tongue. And because it is, I revert back to thinking about a baby, and because of we got a great Christian coming up, and they're at the age now that they're starting to begin to explore stuff.
Right.
And if you know anything, any mothers, real mamas that paid attention to their babies growing up, amen. See, I was a first-time dad, and I was older, so I got to pay attention to everything and detail that my son did as growing up. And one thing that he would do when he would explore, he would put his mouth on it. Y'all agree to that? Amen.
Yeah.
So anything that a child does when they're growing up, the first thing they want to do when they try to explore, whether it's a cell phone, a paper towel, whatever it is, they want to put their mouth on it first. I'm going to lead you somewhere in a minute. And they have to get that, because see, they have to be able to taste it first before they know what it is. See, the problem with a lot of church folks is that we refuse to taste after God. Y'all don't have a church for real. We want to taste everything that makes us feel good. And everything that makes us feel good ain't always good for us. You got your neighbor say, neighbor, develop a taste for God.
Here it is.
Y'all don't have a church for real. Amen. Amen. And these my people here, they're going to taste it. I just want them to taste it. Now, don't put a whole lot at a time, but just taste it. Don't say what it is. You must well quite a lot, baby. I told you not to put a lot. Amen. Brandon, yours was good, though. We don't go to you last, right? All right. Well, what yours taste like, Brother Nick?
Salt.
Tastes like salt. Salt. Ain't that crazy? What yours taste like?
It was sweet and salt.
Oh, sweet and it was a mix.
My God. In a minute.
And what yours taste like?
Chicken.
All right, y'all be seated. Look, the reason that I use sugar and salt as tasters is because you can't tell the difference. Authenticity, come on somebody, and not fake stuff. Come on somebody, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, do you want the real thing? The reason I use salt and sugar is because when it's before you, you don't know what it is.
Right.
What are you getting at, Pastor? I'm trying to help you. Folk will dress up in a mask and you will think that they're something that they are not. But it's up to you to keep praying and asking God for discernment. God, show me the right way. God, give me a taste for you. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Here it is, Proverbs 18:21. I'm going to get it away real fast. But somebody said there is power. There is power in your mouth. But we won't use it for what's good. Look at somebody say, keep the mouth off of me. Don't gossip about me. If you want to talk about me, say it to my face. And let's pray about it together. But we got to get to a place where we develop a taste. Somebody said a taste. Y'all talking back to me this Sunday night, y'all. Come on. We got to develop a taste for what it is that we like. And the problem with some of us is we only want to taste what's good. It's easy to taste something that tastes like sugar all the time. But how many know that in life you ain't gonna have it sugar all the time? Can I talk about four real people that came to church this Sunday that understand that sometimes I feel up, sometimes I feel down, sometimes I feel light, sometimes I feel defeated, sometimes I feel broke, sometimes I feel discouraged. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm human. And sometimes I feel like that. You gotta get to a place where God is calling you to speak life in your dead situation. Make somebody say, sometime you gotta be able to be like David and encourage yourself, because ain't nobody else gonna push you like you push yourself. Ain't nobody else gonna look in the mirror and tell you how good you look all the time. You ain't always gonna have that good morning text all the time. You ain't always gonna have that one somebody that you know will be there for you and tell you now. Yourself. Somebody said power, power, Lord, power. I mean, you're for power. I want God to bless you, but I want you to understand that you have been eating the wrong stuff.
All right.
We know a baby cannot eat a remote control.
Right.
But you will catch them in a teething seasons of their life where they just want to be soothed. Oh, y'all don't hear me talking.
Yeah.
Look at somebody grown and say, your teething seasons are over. It ain't always time for you to be soothed. Can't nobody always rock you to sleep at night. Ain't nobody always gonna pat you on the back and tell you good job. Ain't nobody always gonna tell you how great you are. You ain't 5, you 35.
All right.
Somebody say, you too old for that, too old for that. Me and my son, we have a good relationship, and every time he get his way with me, which is most of the time, because he's the only one. And sometimes I just say yeah. And anyway, but every time he gets his way, and he always say, Dad, you're the great dad. And I say, son, you're the great son. And he say, Dad, you're my only dad. I say, son, you're my only son. And we go back and forth with admiration and how much we love each other all the time. And my wife, she always, I'm getting sick of this bromance that y'all got going on. But here it is. When you speak greatness into something, they receive that. God don't have no church for real. It's in the power of your mouth that they receive, that they believe they are great. It's too many children in the world in St. Louis, Missouri, that don't know how great they are because they never receive the value at home. Nobody ever said it with their mouth, how much I love you, how much I appreciate you. So they go astray and we don't know what happened. You didn't speak to them. You didn't use your mouth as the tool they needed to say, you know what, you are powerful. You are powerful, black girl. You are powerful, black boy. You can do it even if nobody else say you can. Somebody say, yes, I can. Here it is, Proverbs 18 and 21. I won't be long. 18 and 21. This is what it reads. You can be seen on Sunday. Death and life.
All right now.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue.
Yeah.
And they who indulge in it shall eat the fruit of it.
Uh-huh.
For death.
Yeah.
Or life.
Yes.
Somebody say,
use your tongue.
With wisdom. Y'all ain't having no church for real.
Yeah.
Some of y'all going left field, but I wish I had some real sanctified people in church this Sunday that don't mind saying, God, I thank you, even in the face of adversity. God, I thank you, even though my trials are greater. God, I thank you, even though my tribulations are coming in, feel like the storm, I'm never going to tunnel through it. God, I thank you, even when I don't know how my bills going to get paid. God, I praise you, even if I don't know how my children gonna make it. God, I thank you. people. Somebody that's real say holla, holla, hallelujah in this place. What's the highest praise? Somebody holla, hallelujah. Thank God for saving me. If it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, stuff. Amen. Just hold your hand up. You don't have to do much. I want to demonstrate it. Yeah, some of y'all are afraid to demonstrate. But here it is. Whenever somebody has fallen into cardiac arrest, I'm going to help you real fast. The thing that they teach you how to do first, whenever you apply for something in the medical field, whether it's housekeeping or dietary or just watching people or just keeping people, is they want you to be CPR certified.
That's right.
I know the pastor hasn't talked about this before, but I got a little bit more revelation from this, y'all. Because see, the thing that saved the people the most, y'all have no church for me.
Yeah.
The thing that saved the people the most is when you allow mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. I want to take you to a place now, because see, sometimes you have got to allow yourself to be able to be breath life back into your dead situation. Now let me help you real fast. If that person does not receive the proper mouth-to-mouth resuscitation, that person is not going to make it.
That's right.
Yeah.
Because the person that's doing CPR is alive.
Yeah.
Oxygen is flowing through your blood.
Yeah.
So if you are alive, you're able to do the mouth-to-mouth resuscitation.
Yeah.
I'm going to take you somewhere.
Yeah.
It's usually done in increments of counts of 15 because they want to make sure the proper oxygen is flowing from your mouth into their mouth and that your hand compressions are doing the same rhythm. You have to do it in a rhythm. Am I right? Any nurses in here?
Yeah.
Why am I nursing here? You have to do it in a rhythm motion because your heart pumps at a rhythm. Y'all don't have to church. Look at your neighbors and say, I need somebody to just give me a little bit of resuscitation. Let me have you real fast. So, you are at a place and you need CPR. You don't care who do it. Long as it get done. I don't want to have you real fast. But there's somebody in church today that don't mind saying, Father, God, I need you to bring life back into me. God, I need you to bring life back into my mind, life back in my footsteps, joy back in my life. And then somebody say, I need you, Jesus, to bring life back into me. Hold up. Here it is. When you're doing it, you got to make sure that you're breathing properly.
That's right.
The problem with many of us is that we hang around people that are both dead.
Say that.
Oh my God.
That we call those people friends.
Woo!
That's my friend. That's my boo. BFF. She dead and you dead.
Dead. Both dead.
Can't nothing get done with two dead people. Y'all need an EMS or somebody to come see y'all. But many of us would rather hang around what's comfortable.
Yes. All right.
We'd rather do what's comfortable. We don't even pay our tithes because it makes us uncomfortable.
All right.
Y'all don't have no church for real. Never mind the fact that this is the place that I go to get life. Come on, somebody. I don't have a church for here. Can y'all talk back to me if you can? Never mind the place. This is where I go when there is a funeral. This is where I go for a wedding. I need somebody to help me preach now.
Yeah.
Y'all leave me hanging. Don't leave me hanging. Here it is. We got a lot of dead people.
My
that are just laying dead and think they live. Have you ever seen The Walking Dead?
Yes, my face.
Come on, y'all, in church for real. Somebody holler, dead man walking.
Yeah,
that's most of y'all friends. Y'all don't want to really go there. See, sometimes you got to get somebody that's able to say, you know what, there is life after this. Sister or brother, I'm praying for you. The joy of the Lord is your strength, and the strength of the Lord is your joy. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the Lord. You need somebody to speak a life back into you. The greater is he that's called somebody that's in you, and he that is of the word. You need somebody to just know that when my enemies came upon you, they stumbled in faith. You need somebody to know how to press for the mark of the prize of the high calling. You need somebody to speak a life into you.
Thank you.
messing with us. Hallelujah. I want God to do it. Jesus told the man in the Bible, pick up your bed and walk. Before he told him to do that, he asked him a question first. Now the man had been there for 30 long years suffering. He asked him a question. Jesus, why you ask that man if he want to be whole? You know the man want to walk. Well, the man looked uncomfortable. It's why Jesus asked him a question.
All right.
Some of y'all look way too comfortable in church. Way too comfortable in church. You didn't come here for a relaxation moment. You came here to let the enemy know you should have killed me Saturday night. But since I got up Sunday morning, you should have stopped me fighting before I put my shoes on this morning. You should have stopped me last week before you got any more. Thank you. something. Somebody, he's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all, exceedingly, abundantly, above all. There is life in the power of your mouth. Somebody say, use it. Use your power. Because y'all are talking back to me. Y'all looking at me crazy. Somebody say, use your power. Hallelujah. Some of y'all, the reason that you're in the shape you're in is because you had to learn how to open your mouth. You're in search of something that you haven't found that you already got. Somebody say, I got the power. Y'all are talking back loud enough. Somebody, oh, I got the power. Don't be sitting looking cute. This ain't a cute service. Somebody holler, I got the power. We wonder why our children fall by the wayside. We wonder why folk want to commit suicide and fall into deep depressions. Because they ain't got that friend that can do mouth to mouth resuscitation. Somebody holler, you can't be my friend.
Start doing.
she started giving me CPR. Pastor, why you say that? Because whenever somebody's been revived, they don't know they've been revived until they've been revived. You don't know what's going on right now. CPR is going on. But all you know is you get up to the bell. You get up with a new attitude. Come on, somebody. You get up with a new appreciation. Look at somebody and say, real friends that have life know how to bring your strength back to the Lord. Even when you don't know they're praying. Even when you don't know they're crying. Even when you don't know they're pacing the floor. Walking all night. Tossing and turning. Somebody say, I need an intercessor. Let's go. Jesus,
thank you, Lord. Thank
you. I need love today. I'm done. I worship.
She said, when I left my treatment that night, I prayed all night.
All right.
Yeah.
She said, I told God it's not my way, but let it be your will.
Yes, Lord.
And she began to say all the stuff that she wanted to live for and so much that she wanted to do. And so when I pulled up, she said, look, I need my tickets. And I said, look, Miss Key, I got some, but are you getting dialysis because you need that? She said, baby, that was last week. God turned my situation around. Now this is this week. And the doctor said, I'm no longer needing dialysis. But so go forth and be healed. Look at somebody and say, God turned around just when you need him to, just when you want him to, because he's able. In Jesus' name.